Graphic Audio. A movie in your mind.
Graphic Audio presents Archie, Volume 2, by Mark Wade and Veronica Fish, with Thomas Patilli and Ryan Jampol. Narrated by Rob Morira and Bradley Foster Smith, with performances by a full cast.
Chapter 1, Family Time.
A servant sets down a dish of braised beef and microgreen salad upon the long, polished oak table in the opulently furnished dining hall of Lodge Manor, where the Lodge family, Patriarch Hiram, Matriarch Hermione, and raven-haired heiress Veronica silently pick at their meals. Veronica stops scrolling on her phone momentarily to shoot her father an angry glare. Hiram peers over his newspaper and scowls back at her. Hermione facepalms and sets down her silverware.
Veronica, dear, did you want to invite one of your friends to go skiing with us?
Veronica's eyes dart to her mother, then back to her father, who crumples his newspaper in his clenched fist.
Forget it, little lady. That Archie kid should be behind bars for his crimes. If I had hard evidence, he would be.
Veronica sticks up her nose defiantly.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, let me refresh your memory. He destroyed our house.
Veronica pointedly fusses on her phone, refusing to make eye contact with anyone.
I don't know what you're talking...
Stop saying that, Veronica. I've already heard the truth.
Veronica stands up dramatically, knocking her chair over.
Who would tell you something awful like that about Archie?
Well, duh.
She looks over to see a teenager with a leather jacket and slicked back dark hair swagger into the dining hall.
Your boyfriend's a red-headed wrecking ball, Ronnie. Destruction that big? He might as well have signed his name.
Who is this Hiram? And why is he tracking all over my clean carpet?
This is Reggie Mantle, dear. I've hired him as a consultant.
Veronica's jaw drops.
You what?
Reggie picks a piece of lettuce off Hermione's plate and pops it in his mouth.
Hey, I keep informed. I know who's who and what's what in this town.
He saunters around the table.
Your dad's a busy man. He doesn't have time to find dirt on his enemies. I, on the other hand...
Reggie reaches to pick a morsel off of Hiram's plate, who slides it away from him.
Let's just say that people of our station must be vigilant, sadly, of those who would take advantage of us.
Hiram smiles at the lad.
Reggie... The family and I are headed upstate after lunch. Do you like to ski?
Veronica can't take it anymore.
The three of you enjoy yourselves!
She storms out of the room.
Miss Veronica Lodge, you get right back here!
She ignores her father, heading toward the grand staircase.
Veronica!
She stomps up the stairs, shoving past a maid carrying a basket of linens, and enters her room, throwing open the large double windows.
So, how'd it go?
Archie Andrews, in his Riverdale High varsity jacket, clings precariously to a tree limb just outside Veronica's window.
Do you know some cheap hustler named Reggie Mantle?
I know he's not hanging three stories in the air to find out if he can come inside and apologize about a bulldozer accident.
Not now, Archiekins. I need more time to talk Daddy out of hunting you for sport. Reggie has stopped staring at my chest long enough to tell him it was you at the construction site that night.
What? That jerk! How would he know that?
Probably just a guess, but he's really sucking up to Daddy. Call me later.
I'm not normally that clumsy, you know.
Veronica blows Archie a kiss.
Of course you're not.
She closes the windows, and Archie begins to awkwardly climb down the tree. He glances over and sees two figures walking side by side along a wooded path. Archie stops climbing and squints.
Betty?
Sure enough, Archie's ex-girlfriend, Betty Cooper, walks beside the handsome, olive-skinned Saeed Ali, and they're holding hands. Keeping his eyes on the couple, he reaches for a tree limb and closes his hand around thin air.
Chapter 2, Sacred Trust.
Archie brushes leaves out of his disheveled red hair as he walks through downtown Riverdale.
Mantle! Of course he's trying to wedge himself in with Mr. Lodge. Of course he's moving in on Ronnie. Fast, like a cobra. I need a plan.
Archie imagines himself struggling to control a flamethrower as it spews a jet of fire across the lockers and ceiling tiles of Riverdale High School.
I need a better plan, and I know just who would have one.
Archie pulls open the glass door to the cozy diner, known to the locals as Pop's Chocolate Shop. He enters to find his pal Jughead leaning over the counter in agony.
Pop, please. I'm broke, but starving. I need the energy rush.
To do what? My butter churn is more active than you.
Behind the counter, Pop Tate, the portly, aproned proprietor, holds a delicious, juicy hamburger out of Juggy's reach.
No more credit. Show me you can pay or... okay.
Pop sets the plate down in front of Jughead.
Huh?
Jug turns to see Archie standing behind him, holding up a $20 bill.
Huh.
Archie slides in and takes a seat on the stool next to Jughead, who dives into the burger as Pop goes to polish a milkshake glass.
I thought you were mad at me.
The enemy of my enemy is my friend. Mantle is trying to get in good with Veronica's dad and screw this relationship up for me.
Archie runs his fingers through his red hair.
You've had my back enough years to be an expert at fixing bad situations. I need your help.
To destroy Reggie?
No. To save Mr. Lodge.
That makes it less fun. But I owe you at least for the burger. All right. Step one. We need damaging intel on old Evilheart. But where to find it?
Jughead eyes Pop, who sets the milkshake glass on a shelf.
Who in Riverdale knows all, sees all?
A grin spreads across Archie's freckled face.
Yes! That's perfect! Everybody in town comes here, and Pop overhears everything!
Thanks for noticing.
Pop turns to face the two teens with a knowing smile.
I'm right, aren't I?
I've been behind this counter for a long time, Archie. I watched your parents fall in love. The people of Riverdale have trusted me with their secrets since before either of you two were born. Do you know why?
Jughead sneaks his hand into the open door of a pie display case on the counter.
Because you're so charming and smart and handsome, we envy you?
Pop slams the pie case shut.
Because I don't talk. Everything I've ever heard, every piece of gossip, every sob story, every confession stays in the vault of Pop.
Pop turns his attention to Archie.
Think, would you want me to tell anyone about that time you know who shot you down like the Red Baron?
Archie looks ashen-faced as Pop turns to Jug.
Or about where you really found that hat?
Jughead gulps and adjusts his crowned beanie as Pop bends down behind the counter to get some cleaning supplies. Archie leans over the counter to plead with him.
Pop, I get it, but this is an emergency. Can't you break your rule just this one time?
I feel your pain. Reggie Mantle is a $50 haircut on a 10-cent head. But sacred trust.
Archie and Jughead get up from their stools and walk toward the door, dejected.
Got a question for you, though.
Pop spritzes the counter with a spray bottle.
If Reggie, a high school kid, is dishing dirt on a lodge level, where do you think he's getting it from?
Archie blinks.
Yeah. Where would he learn?
Doesn't Reggie's dad work at the newspaper?
Arch and Jug stare at each other in realization.
He publishes it. He's got mad sources. I bet.
Archie grins at Pop.
Thanks, Pop.
I simply asked a question. Sacred trust.
The boys head toward the diner door. Pop wipes down the counter. Suddenly, Archie dashes back and leans in conspiratorially.
Psst. You know anything about this boy Betty seeing?
Psst. Sacred.
Worth a shot.
Chapter 3. Stop the presses.
What'd you expect?
Richard Mantle shows Archie around the modest offices of the Riverdale Gazette.
It ain't like in the old movies, champ. Not a lot of excitement. Like most all local papers, we got bought up by a conglomerate a while back.
Mr. Mantle runs a hand through his thinning black hair.
Nowadays, we get most of our stories sent to us by a national feed. I can introduce you to all my local reporters in about 15 seconds.
They stop near an empty cubicle.
But I can always employ a kid who wants to work.
Thanks, Mr. Mantle. Where can I start? Running down a story? Taking action photos?
What did I just say?
Mr. Mantle frowns as a grizzled, ink-stained old-timer approaches them and holds out an old, ink-blotched apron to Archie.
Here, welcome to the printing department, Red.
Archie is left to his own devices in the print shop. He ties on his apron and pulls out his phone. Extending it arm's length, he flashes the camera a cheesy grin and gives a thumbs up as he takes a selfie. He examines the phone screen, then frowns.
Phone's almost dead. Where can I charge?
He looks around on a nearby desk and sees what looks like a charging cable docked to a desktop computer.
There.
He plugs his phone into the cable. He bends down, picks up a huge roll of paper, and turns to go, knocking over a potted plant perched on the desk. A little later, Archie struggles to carry a tower of ink cans. The top can drops to the ground, and Archie's legs windmill underneath him as he tries to keep his footing in the spreading puddle of ink. To no avail. The grizzled print shop boss runs up, veins standing out on his forehead, and points toward the door. Arch gets up from the ink puddle, unties his dripping apron, and hands it to the fuming boss. His head hanging, Archie pushes through the print shop door onto the loading dock, where Jughead waits for him.
Check it out. It's the man from Riverdale. How goes the spy business?
Terrible. All I've learned is what ink tastes like.
Rather not take this call where others can hear, Counselor.
They look over to see Mr. Mantle walk out from a door around the corner. He talks on his cell phone, unaware of their presence.
I appreciate you getting.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.